Welcome everybody, super cool evening. It's our 11th annual Jazz and Rangers residency concert. And we've had some amazing people on the stage performing and writing music for so many good people. Tonight we're going to have the great Sentinel High School jazz band joining us and playing. Yes. Someone's going to be on stage tonight. So there are a total of 10 tunes that the three jazz bands are playing, and every single one of them is generated by someone that's in this room tonight, which is very, very cool. And also, again, the Sentinel High School Jazz Band joining us. Please welcome, we're going to get things rocking and rolling. Please welcome to the stage the director of our Jazz Band 2, Skyler Mendell.
Thank you. my thing tonight is less talking and more music, so we're going to keep things rolling. Like Rob said, everything on this stage is either composed by James Miley, like that too, you'll meet him in a few minutes, or by one of our student arrangers, and we're going to kick things off with our student arrangers. This next tune was composed, was arranged by senior guitar major Seamus Jennings, and we're going to bring him to the stage now.
I chose There's No Greater Love. The standard was composed in 1936 by Isham Jones. It was the last hit song for the Isham Jones Orchestra before he turned the band over to the leadership of Woody Herman. I chose this song because it's a classic need-to-know jazz standard that comes up at jazz jams, and I figured these guys would need to know that. So I arrange it with the style of Count Basie and Duke Ellington in mind. And it features four soloists as well as the saxophone section. So I hope you enjoy it. Thanks.
Thank you.
It is now my honor to introduce one of my favorite composers and arrangers of all time. Please give it up for Mr. James Miley.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All over town.
Thank you to Nick Barr and his crew back there for live streaming tonight. To the folks that are out there, welcome. Welcome to Missoula from wherever you are. And a big thank you to Lance Boyd, Professor Emeritus, who essentially created the jazz program here in the late 60s and helped establish incredible infrastructure for what we are doing now, which is just an offshoot of our work. All of the band directors, choir directors, orchestra directors, general music folks, and especially their arts coordinator, Monty Prezé. So a big thank you to Monty for all you guys for us. And there's just so much hard work that goes into playing music. All of the students on stage here tonight from UM are also in pep band, they're also in marching band, other jazz bands, they're in small groups, they're in wind ensemble, they're in concert band, they're in orchestra, they're in just so many other things, theater shows, pits, we're playing at MCT, and it's really incredible the experiences they're able to get here, so big thank you for all they do. Yeah. All right, without any further hesitation, this is our last Jazz Band 3 under the direction of Tommy Seipel and Ali Fratkin. Please welcome to the stage our jazz bass teacher, Tommy Seipel.
Thank you.
tune Blues by Five by the renowned piano player Red Garland, arranged by our own Rob Tappet. I'd just like to thank Rob for all his hard work and bringing these great instructors and great artists. He brings all kinds of guest artists and guest arranger here, and it's, for me, it's a pleasure to get to see a lot of these artists work with the bands and stuff. It gives me idea and fuel for ideas to be better at what I do. And anyway, you're already here. It's been an option. But anyway, I'd like to thank Allie too. This is Allie Frapkin. She's been directing Jazz 3 with me all year long, and it's a pleasure to have her help me out and give me some insider saxophone information. Thank you. And they're going to be doing a tune, Chew On This, by James Miley.
I'd also like to thank Jazz 3 because as the first big band, hopefully many in my life that I'll be directing, I could not have had it better. These people are awesome and they're super responsive and so involved and so excited about the music. So this has been awesome. And what better music to get excited about than James Miley? This has also been a huge honor to work on James's music, and I think you guys are like this a lot. So.
Thank you.
Jumped into a first band, Barry Sax spot, playing some really, really tough music. So thank you, Daniel, for that. On stage now is the is this gold? Sentinel Gold Jazz Band. I'm not sure if everybody knows this, but Bruce Nelson, this is your sixth year?
Seventh
year. Grew up around here, went to the University of Montana. Went on to Arizona State University, taught in Highlands High School in Arizona for a little while. And so glad to have him back here for the last almost full 7 years. He and his family, it's been wonderful having him back. I'm not sure if people are aware of this, but it was recently announced that Lewis Nelson is the Arts Missoula Educator of the Year, essentially.
And I, no one deserves it more than Lewis. There are a ton of people out there that deserve it as well, but no one deserves it any more than Lewis. So please welcome to the stage to play some really great music, Lewis Nelson and the Sentinel Gold Jazz Band.
Thank you. right back with Sentinel. We love doing things like this. Neptune, you just heard, obviously, is a jazz standard. We brought it all the turf. We learned that in about 2.5 weeks, and the kids are just, they're slaying. They eat it up for breakfast, so couldn't be happier. This next tune, this is All the Things You Are, the Stan Kenton arrangement. We're going to try to play it as close to the recording as possible. And before we play it, I should probably do my thank yous now, too, because you don't want to hear me talking anymore. The last two, you heard Aubrey on the drums, Andy on the bass, Connor, Mars, and Peyton all took solos also. So next two, you're going to hear from Jeremiah on piano, Jackson on trumpet, and Laura on the upright bass. Both of my bass players are going to play upright this year, and it's just a super treat, and I'm really lucky. So, yeah. And the last thing is going to feature Connor, Jacob on drums, Andy on bass, and yeah. Thank you for having us. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
what's also really cool is how many of those students are learning new instruments. They're taking risks. A lot of these students are like flute players or clarinet players. They've never done jazz before. They're up here taking risks, learning how to play jazz. And for me, that's awesome. So give them a round of applause.
You know what is really cool? So, Lewis is doing fantastic work with these students. This is not easy music by far, especially that last piece, Holy Cow. One of the things I appreciated is...
Did you solo last time?
Yeah.
You came down here and checked.
We had a soloist in a high school band check to make sure the microphone was on and in the right place. There are professionals that forget to do that, so thank you. This piece, Swing State, was written for Fred Stern and the Lawrence University Jazz Celebration back in 2012, back when politics was fun. I don't know what else to say. You're gonna hear from Connor on this one, on the tenor. And I think Jacob, is that right, on drum set? Yes? Okay, I'm winging it. And Andy on the bass. Yeah, there's a lot going on in this tune. So, Swing State, thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks to Lewis.
There's still more music to come.
You'll hear the melody from Skyler, as well as solo, and Sean also solo.
Thank you. Thank you.
TA, and just a sidebar on that, we're going to miss him a ton. He's been phenomenal directing one of the small groups, directing a big band, helping out the marching band, just playing all over the place. He's got a, his sextet is having a CD release party on Sunday at the Zach, if you're Sunday night at the Zach, but like I said, we are just going to miss him. We're going to play his arrangement of Firm Roots. Spencer Scott, you know. We just heard from Spencer. This is Skyler.
Thanks, Rob. Yeah, it's funny because I've been called Spencer since sixth grade because there was a trumpet player in the seventh grade named Spencer. There's a mentor named Spencer, so some things never change. Anyway, it's all right. This tune, Firm Roots, I first heard at a jam session at the Lionel Hampton Jazz Festival, and immediately I was like, man, I gotta go learn that tune. And so I did, and it's been one of my favorite tunes to call at jam sessions ever since then. And so I wanted to, it's not the most known tune in the world, and so I really wanted to introduce it to the band as well, and just all of the music that Cedar Walton writes. The program says something else, but this was written by Cedar Walton. Everything that he writes is really awesome, really special, and this is probably my favorite tune of his. So, hope you enjoy my arrangement of Firm Roots.
It should be faster, that's my bet.
This has been great fun, and I'm really looking forward to these next two pieces of my band's putting in a lot of time. One of the things I tend to encounter with my music is that parts themselves aren't super difficult, but putting it together is often an adventure, and this band has done fantastic work, so I'm grateful to you all. Thank you. This piece actually started as an arrangement, so it's great for an arranging concert. I was trying to do an arrangement of You Don't Know What Love Is, and I got through one phrase and then gave up. But I found this cool thing and then obsessed about that, and by the time I was done, that tune wasn't there anymore. So I put it back in. You'll hear Owen play it in the bass with a couple of the horns, just kind of one phrase. The beginning. And who is playing on this? There are a lot of people. Skyler, Seamus, Dylan, anybody else? Did I get them all? All right. Okay. So this is I Should Have Known. Thank you.
last time you see here for me tonight. We're going to do one more student arrangement and finish off with a really amazing James Miley tune. A big thank you and a big hand for our directors tonight, Tommy Seipel, Alec Fratkin, Skyler Mendell with the Second Jazz Band, as well as Lewis Nelson. Another big hand for all these folks. And sadly, there are a number of folks in this band. This will be the last big band performance. Tomorrow we're going to record all the student arrangements, so we're going to do that. But this is the last time some of these folks will be performing with the band and moving on to other really great things in this world. We just heard from Dylan Bautista on piano, Seamus Jennings on guitar, Billy Balls on drum set, Skyler Mendell, Sean Stinger is graduating, but you'll see him again. Jolene Green on the saxophone. Katie Justin on the saxophone. Okay, this is an arrangement by the pianist who just heard. Please welcome Dylan Bautista.
I wrote an arrangement of Wayne Shorter's composition ESP, and that title is an abbreviation for extrasensory perception. Wayne was one of the most impactful jazz musicians in history. He was a saxophonist and composer whose legacy spanned several decades, and his improvisational and harmonic approaches are highly original and unique, and I love them. So he passed away recently, and I wanted to write this arrangement in honor of his influence in life. Here's ESP.
Thank you.
On behalf of the University of Montana and Sentinel High School, we'd like to present this gift bag to James Miley for doing awesome work. It's great work. Super fun.
Come for the jazz and stay for the presents. This has been great fun for me, and I always enjoy working with new-to-me musicians. But this last piece actually has a very long history between myself and Rob Tapper. And Rob's one of my favorite people, and he's a musical hero of mine. I don't know a better teacher. He's a fantastic musician and just an all-around inspirational guy to hang out with. So thank you, Rob, for being here. Many years ago, before he was even here in Montana, he was teaching out in Eastern Washington, and I was in a group called Bug, which I don't know how we got to that name, but it was one of those. There's a concert, you need a name, and somebody said Bug, and then it was a quintet. There was an alto saxophonist named Peter Epstein, who teaches down at the University of Nevada, Reno. My brother, Jeff Miley, who teaches at a couple of colleges as a guitarist down in Los Angeles, was playing guitar. I played piano. I was also teaching. We had a drummer named Brian Hamada, who was teaching drum set down in Fresno at the City College and State University. And the bassist, Roger Shute, who was on the faculty at Fullerton College. So everybody was a teacher. And what we would do is we would write a bunch of music, get together once a year for a week, and then go on tour, and at the end make a record. We had a great time. And that band was a wonderful resource for me of just these wonderful musicians who would take things that I wrote and make them so much better and more alive. And we had a nice run. We played from around 2005 or so until 2015, so a good 10 years, ended up with three, post-pandemic time means nothing. I think there's three albums over that 10-year period. The unfortunate part of the story is that the bassist, Roger, passed away in 2016 from cancer. And then Brian, the drummer, passed away 2 years later from cancer as well. And so we just retired the band at that point. It's not worth trying to make something new there. It was, they really made that ensemble. And in, it's Rob back there, what year was it? 2019? Are you hiding, or are you out here?
Yeah, 17.
Well, some, yeah, I think the Allstate Band, Rob was helping with the Allstate Band in California and commissioned a piece in honor and memory of Brian Hamada, the drummer, because he was from Fresno. Almost everybody there knew him, had worked with him, had a huge legacy of musicians that had studied with him and gone on to do amazing things. So I started working on this piece, and then I incorporated hints of Roger in there as well, and ended up with a really long and complex big band arrangement of an original composition that has all these little Easter eggs in it. And so what you're gonna hear is, there's a quote from Tears for Fears. It's kind of messed up, but it's in there, you know what happens. That was one of Brian's guilty pleasure bands. He was into all those 80s synth bands and had a huge CD collection. If you went to his house in the studio, there's all these jazz records. And then The Fix and Tears for Fears and Depeche Mode, like on a whole wall or something. So there's a quote from Tears for Fears. There are a couple of quotes from Bug albums that we had made together. And at the very end, and this is it's worth explaining because you can listen and see how it unfolds. That group of alto saxophone, piano, guitar, bass, drums is all that's left at the end of this piece. And the bass drops out first. And then the drums drop out, and the piece finishes with just the trio. So this is Toshio, which is Brian's middle name. It means wise man, which indeed he was. And thank you again to Rob and to these students for doing amazing work. You have a great thing going here. So keep doing what you're doing. All right, hopefully I'm gonna get the right tempo on this tune. I'm bad habit of doing these modular kinds of things where there's three times or seven times or four, who knows how many times. And this one, I think we're only doing repeated sections twice, like a normal piece of music. So I want to make sure I'm cueing things right.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks to Rob, to Skyler, Ali, Tommy, Kevin, everybody who made this happen. Thank you all for coming.